I'm your host, Kim Carey, and today we have Maggie Varney, who is the CEO and founder of Wigs for Kids, and joining us with Maggie is Jaylene Davis, who is the ambassador and spokesperson for Wigs for Kids. Thank you for coming in. It's been a while, but it's good to have you back.
It has been. Well, thank you for having us in again. We always appreciate the opportunity to reach out in our community and let people know about the program and what's going on.
Right. It's always good to see you, Maggie. So we'll start by telling the audience, what is Wigs for Kids? How did you start it, and what is the purpose?
Wigs for Kids is a local grassroots nonprofit organization, and what we do is provide wigs and support services for children who are experiencing hair loss. There are many different reasons that children experience hair loss. Mm-hmm. You know, most of us think of cancer, which is the obvious one, and 65% of our children do have cancer. But we also service children who have alopecia, like Jaylene, trichotillomania, which is the obsessive compulsive disorder where children pull their hair out, lupus, blood disorders. There are many different reasons that children experience hair loss, and I'm very proud to say that since we were here last, you know, we now have 8 hospitals throughout Michigan that service pediatric oncology, and we service all 8 of them. We take care of their kids.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So what motivated you to give back in this way?
Well, I have had the honor and privilege of serving adult patients in our community, and I still do that. Mm-hmm. I teach a class called Look Good, Feel Better, where I go to local cancer centers and hospitals, and I help adult patients deal with the appearance-related side effects of treatment. Most of us know of someone or ourselves who have been through treatment, and we know that it causes a lot of physical changes with the hair, skin, and nails. And the medical teams are so busy helping us and saving our lives, and this sometimes is not addressed. And so we are trained and certified to work with the patients, and it was through that that I had a 16-year-old child come to my class and ask me if I could help her. And I said, well, don't you just go down the street to a wig salon and buy a wig? Because I really didn't sell wigs.
Okay.
And she said, they don't have Wigs for Kids. And I said, really? And she said, no, they're all old lady looking.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
So, well, you can imagine at 16, that's what she thought.
Sure.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a great story.
And that was how it really got started, was a child reached out to me, and I'm a licensed cosmetologist, and I own a full-service salon, and I thought, well, you know, we could help a few kids.
Yes.
Maybe we could help a few.
Yes.
And having no idea that there are so many children that do need our help.
And therefore, we have Wigs for Kids.
We do.
And Jaylene, you look beautiful.
Oh, well, thank you.
It's been a while since I've seen you, and you've lightened up your look. You look absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you.
So why don't you tell the audience how you got connected to Wigs for Kids?
I was diagnosed with alopecia areata at the age of 8, and actually didn't come in contact with Miss Maggie or Wigs for Kids until I was 10. Mm-hmm. So there was a huge gap in which I was struggling with my disorder and struggling with my new diagnosis, and was going around, and my mom was trying to find something to help her daughter.
Yes.
First, we started off with a do-rag and just wearing a bandana tied, and I was called, you know, a boy or an alien, and that didn't work, so we went to the mall and bought a wig, which is completely synthetic. You cannot do anything with them, and they tear apart pretty easily, and that didn't go well. And then we finally came across another organization called Locks of Love, which is very familiar with most people. It's the most easiest one to get accessible to, and unfortunately, they just weren't personable enough for me. They weren't a family, and that's what I needed. I needed somebody to boost me up again and show me that I was beautiful.
Yes.
We found Wigs for Kids through a Google search, and it's a life changer since then, completely.
Now, also share your first encounter that you had.
Yeah, before I lost my hair, I was a confident young lady going off, performing in Broadway in New York. I was acting and modeling and doing everything I wanted to do, pageants included. And then I was diagnosed, and I just felt unworthy of it all. Didn't want to do any of it. And the first time I met Miss Maggie, I will never forget. It was in her old salon. It was a very small corner where she had all of her wigs set up. And she goes to give me a hug, and I just tense, completely frightened of what this was going to occur and what she was going to say to me and if she was going to judge me, especially when I took off my wig that I received from the mall. And I didn't want her to judge me, and I was just so frightened and timid and introverted that it was completely different from who I am now.
It is. Yeah. It is. Because you are so full of life and outgoing and
Thank
confident.
You.
And you are the ambassador.
Mm-hmm.
So what has that been like for you?
Being an ambassador just means that I've been blessed enough to be welcomed into the family at Wicks for Kids. You know, there's thousands of children across Michigan that have had this opportunity, and hopefully one day we get to say nationwide opportunity. But recently I've signed on as their spokesperson, which has allowed me to share my stories. I mean, I have 9 years worth of stories that I'd love to share, and I love hearing the stories of the parents talking about how their little girl or their little boy is going through the same thing, and they just cannot wait for their child to grow up and be able to say that they are going through the same thing that I've gone through. And just to have that role model inspiration that Miss Maggie is and that I'm trying to be throughout this organization, it's truly a blessing that I know I was meant to be here.
Okay. And so let's talk about the type of hair you're you're wearing today. It's a lace front, and
yes, ma'am.
It is half human hair and
yeah.
half synthetic.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
Tell us some more about that.
It's awesome because it stays the way that it's made. That, like I said, synthetics usually are made to be a certain way. So it's always curly. I don't have to worry about it. But if I always want to touch it up because it is made with some human hair, I can. And it allows you to put heat on it and as well as wash it and take care of it and upkeep it the way that most synthetics aren't able to. But it's breathable enough so that I can run errands and go do pageants or go model and act without having to worry if it's going to slip or fall off.
And that makes you feel very, very confident.
So confident, and it's something that I, like I said, I can't stress it enough, blessed.
But you were a part of the process, and that's the difference in Maggie's organization when you went in to get fitted.
Yes.
You were a part of that process. Describe that for us.
I was the leader of my ship, and that's the best way to say it, that everybody else was supporting me. It wasn't a company saying, here's our wig, this is what we make, and you get it.
Right.
It was Miss Maggie saying, here's what we can offer you. Which one do you want? What part do you want? What color? What length? What, you know, how thick do you want your hair? And for somebody that hadn't had hair for 2 years, hadn't had that option, and her whole life never really actually had the option to choose from what color I wanted, it was truly indescribable. It was the first moment in my life where I can truly say I knew I was on the right path.
Yes. And you do wear different colors.
Oh, yeah.
You have a red.
Yeah.
Wig.
Red and brown and pink and blonde, every color you can imagine. And that's that is truly one of the great things about being able to wear wigs, having hair loss, is that you get to change it on a dime, not pay anything because of, you know, Wigs for Kids and all the wonderful sponsors, and also be able to go out and rock it.
Well,
and she does.
Lady Gaga better look out.
Yes, ma'am.
So, Maggie, tell us what's been going on with your facility. It's growing, and you're doing a lot of changes around there.
We are. I was listening to Daylene's story, and my eyes are welling with tears because I'm so touched that she expresses so well what our children feel and the transformation, and that's what we strive for. It's not just about putting wigs on their heads.
Right.
It's about helping them to heal, to heal emotionally, socially, psychologically, as well as physically. So not only do we offer the wigs, but we offer all these support services for the children and the families. So we have grown. So when we started in our early time, it was about putting the wigs on their heads. And now we've expanded those services, all encompassing for the whole family, to help all of them work together so that they can go on with their life and just be a normal kid. That's what they, that's all they want to do.
That's all they want to do.
And you can clearly see by Jaylene, she certainly is not a victim.
She is not a
no,
victim.
No, she is not. And she, and that's a choice. And and our kids don't want to be looked at that way. They just want to be a normal kid.
Right.
So we are, and we are growing. And, you know, we have this wonderful facility now.
And the only one, the only wig center, hair loss center for children that offers therapy. And I it really needs to be stressed that, like others, you can go and get a wig, no problem. But Wigs for Kids is the only place you can go and not only feel good on the outside, you know, shown how to wear your eyebrows, shown how to do your eyelashes, shown how to wear your wig and how to style it yourself, but also then go into an art class and express the emotions that you're going through. Go into a music class and learn how to cope with that loss that you're experiencing and also turn it into a positive thing. This is the only place.
That is a great work.
Thank you. It's
a
true.
Great work.
Well, I don't do it alone. I have wonderful, wonderful volunteers. Mm-hmm. I have a great educational and medical team. They're all volunteers. They're all professionals, licensed professionals that step up and help us. And of course, as she mentioned, our wonderful donors that grow their hair out. You know, it's a 2-year commitment to grow your hair out and yes. donate their hair. And that's the hair that we use to make mm-hmm. the wigs. So if you donate your hair, it's walking around on some kid's head in our community, which oh, is wow. kind of neat.
That's great.
And all of our donors who, because it still costs us $800 to take that hair and make it into a wig. Mm-hmm. So if you could purchase these wigs, which you can't for children, they would be anywhere between $1,500 to $3,000. We have a company that makes them for us for $800 per wig, but we have all the wonderful people who, because we have no funding from the government or the mm-hmm. state or insurances, so it's through the kindness and generosity of individuals, civic groups, schools, churches, clubs, and corporations and businesses that support us is how we've been able to continue and grow. Mm-hmm. We have never turned a child away.
That is incredible. And mm-hmm. you have a gala coming up.
We do.
Yeah.
Once a year, we do an annual gala. And this really is in celebration for our children. It really is all about the kids. You know, you go to a lot of fundraisers, and it's for children, but you don't see children there. You come to ours, and you'll see about 200 plus.
Children running around yes. with chocolate all over their faces,
exactly.
having a good time.
Yeah.
Now, are they all recipients as well?
They are. They are, and they bring their friends and their family. And so we have about 800 guests at our gala, and we usually sell out every year, okay. thank you, God, to our community that supports us.
That's
We're
right.
fortunate.
That's right.
And but it's at the Barrister Gardens, and it's September 18th on a Thursday evening. It starts at 6 o'clock, but it is not your typical fundraiser. Because our children entertain us. And I mean, they're professionals. And
wow.
They're the entertainment. Mm-hmm. Yes, yeah. absolutely. Yeah. There's some talent out there.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a bunch of it with yes. our kids. And so yeah. they get up and they are entertainment. We have a great, great food, good time mm-hmm. with friends.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very kid friendly. We have a lot of activities going on. And the kids.
They definitely love the candy bar. And now it's turned into a candy room.
Yes.
It's a whole entire room full of candy and chocolate. And then you have the raffles and the baskets. And, I mean, it's...
And this year we're adding the Princess Tea Party.
Oh, wow.
So we have
so much.
We have Miss Jaylene, who is going to be crowned as our official Wigs for Kids princess.
Oh, wow.
And we have another new little princess this year, too.
Really?
We've never had... Now we have our own princess.
You have your own princess.
We really have our own. So,
oh, my goodness.
We love and appreciate her.
And then you will be performing.
Yes, mm-hmm. ma'am.
And
yes.
What will you be doing?
I will be singing. Like I said, I do a lot of competitions, and I do like to perform. And one of my favorite performances of all time is Les Miserables.
Mm.
And it speaks to everyone. You know, like, we cannot stress enough these children go through mm-hmm. things that they shouldn't go through at a young age. And that... performance of Les Miserables always gets to me. So I'll be singing I Dreamed a Dream to hopefully show these children and show their families not to give up, that always dream your dreams and you can go anywhere. And then hopefully I'll be able to lighten up the mood with a little bit of story time with the children and show them that, you know, hey, you're bald, but you're beautiful.
That's
and
right.
nothing
Absolutely.
Can stop you.
That's
nothing
great.
Can stop
That's
you.
That's right.
Oh, well,
and you're
you.
Such a great role model and example
thank
for
you.
Our children.
Thank
Absolutely.
You.
Well, thank you, Jaylene. But before we close out, Maggie, is there a website you'd like to give as a contact
Absolutely.
Or any additional information?
I always like to take the opportunity to reach out. If you ever know of a child out there in need of our services, please contact us. We make it really simple. You can go online, visit us at our website, www.wigswiththenumber4kids.org, and print out an application. It's a 2-page application. You call us that day, we get you in the next day. There's no waiting, and there's no costs involved. We qualify no one, we charge nothing, and we help everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Children from ages 3 through 18.
What about different ethnic backgrounds?
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
Oh,
we help awesome. All children.
That's awesome.
All children. Okay. We have children that come from every race, religion, and background, and financial background, and we don't care. We just embrace them and love them and help them heal and do anything we can to make their life a little easier.
That's awesome.
them and their families. So we're located on Harper in St. Clair Shores, and our phone number is area code 586-772-6656. So they can also reach us by phone.
Okay. Well, it was good to see you again, Jaylene.
Yes, thank you very much. Thank you.
You are just absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
And Maggie, it's always, always a pleasure
thank
to
you.
See you and continue to do the great work that you're doing
oh,
in the community.
You. Thank you. Thank you so much for having us on.
No problem. Well, that's going to do it for us here at Reaching Out. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.